Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's ask the question, who owns the code that you write? Okay, so today I want to talk very quickly about ownership. Who owns your code? See, one of the questions I get asked by clients a lot is, after this project is over, how much of this do you own and how much of it do we own? And for me, my answer has always been the same. You own all the code that we do for you, all the work that we do, you own, and you own the entire project unless we're using some third-party library and you have to check out the licensing on that, and then you depending on what we use it, but we'll try to use everything that we have total ownership of. Because this is something that really concerns me as a developer myself when I put apps out onto the app, so I want to make sure that I own everything. Right? And some of the clients that I've talked to, they've worked with other developers who they didn't have that kind of situation, where the developers would maintain some ownership of it. And usually when I dig a little bit further, because that seems a bit wrong to me, but when I dig a little bit further, it's because they use app builder software like biz apps and things like that, where they can't give the code over. It's just not possible, which is why I don't really particularly like those kind of platforms, right? But whenever I hire a developer or a designer, my expectation is that the work they do for me, I own that work, and the work that they do for themselves, they own that work, right? So it's just because they did it doesn't mean they're the owner of it. That's the downside of client apps. I mean, client apps are like you're selling your time and your skills for money. That's what you're doing. So you're building something for someone else and it belongs to them. That's always been the way that I thought about it. Now, I have worked with other developers where they had like a licensing scheme with their clients, right? And I think, dude, that is a really good business model, right? I was talking with one developer. We were both working on this one project together. He was working on the back end. I was working on the front end. And his part was licensed to the clients. And my part was like just one big balloon payment. I hand over the app and we're done, right? And he had like a much smaller upfront cost or much smaller upfront payments, but it was residual. Like he's still getting paid for it now. And I'm done. I finished that thing a year ago. All right, so there's other ways of doing it, but he also makes sure in his contract that he owns the back end of the system, right? He owns the infrastructure. He's charging them for, you know, the hosting and the rent and all that kind of stuff, right? Where I'm just like, I hand over the code and I give it to him, which may be a little bit naive, right? I once had a designer who had taken some of the images that he had done for me. Like I hired him for like several months, right? And then one day he sent me his website. He said, hey, I set up this website. Can you have a look at it? He was very excited. So I had a look at it, right? And on his website, he had a bunch of images that I had, a bunch of my images that he had done for me and a bunch of our client images that he had done for a client. So I told him, hey, you know what? This is really cool, but you can't use the client images. You can use mine. I own them, but I give you permission to use them because you did them, but these belong to the client. They don't belong to either you or me. And he was really confused about it. He said, yeah, but I made them. I should be able to use them on my website. And I was like, no, you've been paid for those images, right? You cannot use those without the permission of the client. That is their intellectual property, right? And he was very confused about it. And this is something I have to make very clear to developers and designers that I hire that kind of arrangement exists. So my question to you guys today, have you ever had a situation like that? If you've ever done work for a client, what is your expectation? I mean, and I'm not talking about like a specific function. Like I've got certain functions that I reuse again and again because they're not necessarily, it's not the intellectual property of the client. But a lot of the times it's images and the whole thing. Like if I hired a developer and they had a function that it took them a while to write and they reuse that function in a few different apps for other clients, that doesn't bother me. If they reuse the entire code base, yeah, we need to have a conversation about that. But let me know what you guys think. What is your expectation? If you were to hire a developer or if someone hired you, who owns the code when you're done? That's my question for today. Code ownership, I think, is one of the biggest things that I think about a lot. I want to make sure that when we build something, that we own it. But when we build something for ourselves, we own it. We build something for somebody else, they own it. So anyway, that is it for today. I will talk to you guys again tomorrow.